Big Fish started 15 years ago as a casual game studio. Over the years, we became a powerhouse in developing mobile games for multiple platforms. We've been making games for Android since its inception. It's been great to see how their focus on developer tools and also their global reach has helped us make games better for a much wider audience. One of the great things now is we're able to use tools like Open Beta to really get early access and information to allow us to actually do more of a user-centered design-focused development.
Historically, we've put games into pre-launch that we were already very comfortable with, and we just waited to sort of validate that we had what we thought we had. Now that we're using Open Beta, we're really willing to put a game out there to the world much earlier in its process. Cooking Craze is a time management game in which you play from the perspective of a chef. Big Fish published Cooking Craze working with a partner named Elefun who developed it. This is their first free-to-play time management game, and it's super fun. They really knocked it out of the park.
When comparing our previous game launch to our more recent one, Cooking Craze, where we used open beta, we saw a dramatic reduction in crash rate, about 21% decrease. We also got a much higher volume of feedback as well, about 10x. The other thing that we noticed based on the larger sample size was with Cooking Craze, we had no surprise 1- and 2-star reviews, whereas our past game release, we had a few that were uncharacterized. One of the benefits of being an open beta is you can still be released globally. This allows our marketing teams to optimize their processes, their paid acquisition partners and campaigns that they weren't able to do in a geolock soft launch.
Before using open beta, we would pre-release our games into a small number of soft launch countries, and we would use them to see all the metrics that we're looking for. With open beta, we're going worldwide right off the bat, and we're able to gather data from a much wider range of players that is much more representative of what we'll see when we go to our official launch. With open beta, we have said, no restrictions, go out, go live, see what happens, and we're able to react if there's a problem instead of assuming that there would be a problem.
We're looking at the core game KPIs. We're looking at the team that's delivering the game and their ability to scale. We're looking at a lot of the metrics that are in Android Vitals.
When we're in pre-launch, we start by looking at retention numbers. Are people coming back on the second day? Are they coming back on the third day? We're typically looking at D1, D7, D30 retention. Then we start looking at the monetization metrics. But once we're comfortable with those metrics, then we know that it's time to start moving toward our official launch. We were able to increase our retention numbers fairly significantly. We went about 9 percentage points up on D1 retention, about 8 percentage points up on D7, and about 5 percentage points up on D30. One of the great things about open beta is that we're able to gather feedback from the beta players without having public-facing reviews and ratings. So we're able to fail harder without having sort of negative reviews that stick on our permanent record for the lifecycle of the game.
My recommendation for all developers out there is to take a close look at the tools in the Play Console. We use a lot of them and we benefit from them tremendously. Just in the last year, we've changed the way we've developed and released our games substantially based on open beta alone.